Today we're unboxing the ComfyGo Majestic IQ 9000. This is the auto recline version. This is also the plus model, but the regular model should be boxed the exact same way. We're going to start with getting a knife, and they usually tape the box shut. So we're going to take our knife just carefully. Don't want to cut down into the box. We don't want to potentially damage any products. We open it up, and here's the first thing we see. I'll tilt it so you can see. Sometimes there's, I believe there is a piece of foam on top of this. I had to unbox this already to remove the batteries, but this is how it comes shipped. Usually a piece of foam up top. And we have what is most likely our joystick in this box here. Got our charger here. Then this one comes with the upgraded cushion, but they do send you the normal back cushion as well. Then you also have like a rear pad, and then you have your calf pads as well. So I'm gonna set these to the side. We have our arm bag sitting up top here. And then the unit from here, there's a couple ways to do this. It does weigh a little bit. If you can lift it all the way up, that's a possibility. If you have a second person, you can tilt the box down and have one person hold the box and just kind of slide it out. That's the method I'm going to show you today. If these don't work, you can always just grab your knife and carefully cut the corners of your boxes and then have the box fall to the side. But I'm going to slide this out of here. I'm going to turn it to the side so you can see what I'm doing. And I've got our wheels facing down just to not potentially scratch the unit. But as you can see, it kind of slides out pretty easily. I'm holding the box one-handed, and we can just slide it out. That, in my opinion, is the easiest way to do this. Now, inside the box in the bottom, we've got our headrest and then another little pad in there. We have our anti-tip wheels. And then just check the bottom in case anything loose comes out. These are not secured in like a Ziploc bag, so I see a headrest screw was in there. So just check the bottom, make sure there's no screws or anything floating around. But that is it as far as the box goes. I'm gonna take a moment to move some of this plastic wrap and then we will continue to assemble the chair. So I've got the unit sitting straight up like this because I did want to show one little thing before we proceeded. Is I'm going to move the footplate out of the way, and there is a storage compartment under here. If I unzip this, in these storage compartments we actually have our battery connector cables, so I'm just going to preemptively get those out. There they are. So this will connect to your battery when we do eventually hook that up. So I just wanted to go ahead and get that out of here. So here is the unit out of the box. I'm gonna flip this footplate forward, and then it actually just manually folds. So there's a little bit of resistance when you do this. That is normal. So I'm kind of pulling back here and then pushing forward on the seat. And you can see it unfolding just like that. Now back here, this is also the auto recline version. The manual recline version should also be packaged the same way. So back here, once you do have it all the way unfolded, you do want to, there's a little latch back there, which actually I accidentally locked it. There it is. I had it under here when I folded the unit. So you want to have that up, fold the unit all the way out, and then snap that latch shut. And now the chair will not fold in on you. So that's just a securing mechanism as a part of this chair. So you can see the front. If you get the upgraded cushion, it's already installed. This is the silver one with the upgraded blue cushion. Next thing we're gonna do is hook up the batteries. So to access the batteries are underneath the storage compartment here. We're just gonna tuck this out of the way so we can see them. We have two airline approved batteries here. And they did two batteries so that they could be airline approved instead of one big battery. Those cables we pulled out of storage earlier. I guess you could have done that now, but one of the things is an adapter right here. This adapter goes into both batteries. I had it backwards. This one goes in here. This one goes in here. And it goes that way. And then this connects into here. This cable is connected to the chair. So we're going to connect that. And now we have both of our batteries connected. And then the other cable we pulled out, this is if you want to charge your batteries off board. This goes into here. And then this will connect into your charger, which you would then plug into the wall if you wanted to take the batteries out and then bring them inside. The next thing I'm going to do is unbox the joystick. It will be in this box here. I'm just going to cut the tape. I believe there's other stuff in here as well. Yes. So we have our remote control. We have our owner's manual. And then we also have our joystick. So the joystick is pretty straightforward. Comes default right-hand side. You see this cable here. It can very easily be swapped to the left-hand side. It's just a few zip ties. You just run that cable to the other side. As far as installing this, I'll lift that up so you can see a little bit better. So you see there's a screw under here. I'm going to make sure that screw is loosened. And then the joystick just slides in there. See, I don't have the screw loose enough. I'm going the wrong way. Looking at it upside down makes it weird. Okay, so the screw is loose enough, slides in, and then you just tighten the screw again. There we go. Now the joystick is installed. It would be the same on the left side if you want to do it on the left side. Then all we have left is our cable here. It only goes one direction. Don't try to force it. Just kind of lightly put them together and then spin it until it goes in. And then you have a little metal ring that's threaded, and you'll just screw that in and tighten it. And now that prevents our joystick from coming undone. And then next we're going to install the tip wheels. So here's our anti-tip wheels that come with the unit. They have a little post in here, and it slides right into there. So you'll notice with the chair on the ground like this, it's going to be kind of hard to get it in. You might have to lift the chair just a little bit. There we go. Slide those in. Then they should snap. And now the tip wheels are installed. They're both the same, so it doesn't matter which side they go in, but you want to add them to both sides. There we go, both sides. And make sure that pin is out on both sides as well, so that way it doesn't turn. But it is normal for it to be a little loose like this. So now we're going to install our headrest. The headrest mounts right here. We have our two headrest screws. What I'm going to do, I'm going to go ahead and remove this entirely. Since I have the upgraded cushion, I'm going to replace this anyways. I get this fancy blue one. If you don't have the upgraded cushion, you can install a headrest and then just wrap this back around it if you want some padding for this. But I'm going to remove that. So the headrest just mounts right here. We have our screws. It's pretty straightforward. I'm just going to start one and start the second one. Apparently I didn't start it well enough. There we go. Then these screws, you can also, they lift up and you can spin if you need to hand crank them, or if they're like running into each other over here. Or if you're like me and you want both your screws facing the same direction. So that is how the screws go in, and then the headrest is now mounted. From here, we can take our upgraded cushion. It should go around like that, and it should just Velcro underneath. There we go. So some of the other features you get with this unit, you have a calf support. And all that does is it just wraps around here, wraps around this side. And there's our calf support. And then we have our arm bag here. It's got just two straps You can strap it over the arm, but it just kind of hangs off the side. You can put it on whichever arm you want, and it'll just hang there like this. Also included with this chair is a remote control that comes in this box. It does get shipped with batteries as well. It is already programmed to your chair, so you're just going to hold the power button. I believe it's about 3 seconds. You'll see a green light come on, and now I can control the chair. You just hold it down and turn it off. With this unit, if I do power on the joystick, there is a power button up here. I push it, we should have the screen light up. And if I try to drive it and it starts beeping at me like this, that means we are in neutral. So neutral on the back of the chair is these levers right here. I'm gonna go ahead and turn this off again. Neutral is so you can push the chair freely, but the chair will not drive in neutral. We do want to flip these two yellow levers up into the drive position. I turn my power on, and now the chair drives. So we're out of neutral. So if you hear that sound, your chair is in neutral. But this has been the unboxing of the ComfyGo Majestic IQ 9000 Auto Recline Power Chair. If you have any other questions, or if you like this unit or are interested in one of these units, please give us a call. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Mark.
And my name is Alex. We're co-owners of Mark's Mobility.
I started this company in 1995.
We sell many products, not just what you see in this video. If you have any questions or concerns, please call us at the number below at 800-677-6293. Thank you, and have a wonderful day.